print, email, Facebook, Twitter. More Dockers players proud of Ross Lyon in wake of a tough week for the club. It has been a difficult fortnight at the Coburn headquarters of the Fremantle Football Club. The club, the players and the staff have endured intense scrutiny and ongoing commentary stemming from revelations of two separate complaints against Ross Lyon, with questions around the culture of the club compounded by Brad Hill's untimely brush with the law last weekend. But within the four walls, belief in the embattled coach was unwavering, according to midfielder Connor Blakely. Obviously, with all the external noise and the press conferences, and all the scrutiny that Ross was under, obviously it was a tough week for him, Blakely told ABC Grandstand following the Dockers' 30-point win over St Kilda at Perth Stadium. But to see the way he operates under so much pressure, it makes you proud of him, it makes you want to perform for him and work really hard for him. And that is exactly what the Fremantle players did, in holding off a third-quarter charge from the Saints to record a much-needed win and end the week on a high note. "We made that a focus this week as a group to perform really well and to make him proud, and I think the way we responded in the third quarter to St Kilda coming pretty hard at us," Blakely said. "It wasn't a normal week, but you don't go through those weeks very often. As a playing group, we didn't really think about it too much. Obviously, it didn't really affect anyone, and the way that we went about it was really pleasing." Players kept in form. Pressure on the club increased on Thursday as major sponsors Woodside and Programmed issued a public "Please explain" to the Dockers. Speculation about the future of Lyon reached fever pitch on Friday morning, as the club announced a joint press conference with CEO Steve Rosich, club president Dale Alcock and Lyon. But Blakely said the players were kept informed by management, and did not buy into the running commentary around the coach. "On our final training session, after we finished weights, he got us into the lecture theatre, and Steve Rosich and Ross just spoke to us about what was going on and how there was going to be a press conference," he said. "You hear all the external noise, and people are always talking about Ross is going to get the flick and all these sorts of things, but internally we knew that was the furthest thing from the truth." Lyon told the playing group he would deal with the speculation, and that they should just focus on their match preparation. "I think that's what everyone did," Blakely said. Leaders stood up. The 22-year-old, who finished the game with a career-high 35 disposals, said the leadership from the club's senior players, including captain Nathan Fife, and midfielders David Mundy and Lachie Neal, helped the young brigade put the external pressure to one side. "It just showed that no matter how much scrutiny your club's under, and no matter how much external noise there is, internally, if you keep it together then that's not going to affect anything," Blakely said. "It was a tough week, but we weren't distracted at any point." The Dockers have balanced the ledger at 4 wins and 4 losses, but face a potentially season-defining month, with a trip to SCG to play the Swans next weekend, before matches against North Melbourne, Collingwood, and